Frick. The courts? Okay. There are 4 amendments to the Constitution about who can vote. Describe one of them. Okay. We have, I believe it was the 19th Amendment. I am taking a U.S. citizenship test as American to see if I would pass. I feel good about this answer. Let's see, what are they giving me? What I said's not on here. Every citizen must vote in every federal election. Not true, you don't have to vote. Citizens 25 older can vote. Not true, you have to be 18. Anyone in the U.S. during an election can vote. Not true. Some people, if you live in the U.S., you can't vote. Like, for instance, if you're not a citizen, I'm pretty sure. You do not have to pay a poll tax to vote. This one's true. You do not have to pay taxes to vote. Yes. I don't vote. I'm that kind of anarchist. I mean, hey, you do you, man. I'm not going to speak on whether or not, you know, you should vote or not. I'm just chilling. What is one thing Benjamin Franklin is famous for? Is he the guy that invented the light bulb? Or was that Thomas Edison? I feel like I shouldn't be getting those two mixed up, but I am. Benjamin Franklin was the guy that got struck by lightning? Maybe that's why I got them confused. Not giving answers. My lips and fingers are sealed. Good. I know he signed some kind of important document. AKA what Taco said, Founding Father, but I wouldn't have known. Like, I wouldn't have put the Founding Father thing together until you said that. So, my answer, he signed an important document. Let's see what's here. Writer of Poor Richard's Almanac purchased the Louisiana Territory from France and was a president during the Civil War. Okay. Oh god. Was he ever president? Was Benjamin Franklin president? I feel like he wasn't. I think he was just a founding father. I feel like he might have done this. I don't know why. But this gives Benny vibes. Like, Benny Franklin probably did this. Did he fight for civil rights, though? I don't know. Oh my god. Wait, what was the correct answer then? I guess it'll show me at the end. It was B? Really? He wrote Poor Richard's Almanac? What even is that? Oh my god, he did. Okay, but like, what was it about? To provide affordable information to common people. Oh, wait, that's kind of sick, actually. Good on you, Ben Franklin. Good on you, Benny. I didn't know you did that, though. What is one promise you make when you become a United States citizen? You'll, like, follow the Constitution and the amendments. That's probably a promise you have to make. Pay taxes for traveling to other countries. Do you have to do that? I don't think so. Serve the nation when needed. I think it's C or D. What I think of serve the nation, I'm assuming they mean, like, getting drafted for war or whatever. As a woman, they're not going to draft me. Thank God, by the way. Thank God. Please, don't do that. I think offer housing to U.S. soldiers is one of the, like, the first amendments or something. It's definitely an amendment, I think, is quartering for soldiers. And that hasn't been, like, overruled or whatever, changed in the Constitution. Can you change the Constitution? I don't even know. But I think it's D. Move D, and if it is D, then that means that I was correct about the amendment thing, because I'm pretty sure this is an amendment. What? It must have been C then. I guess it was probably C. Whatever. Who signs bills to become laws? Oh my god. Is that the Supreme Court? I want to say Supreme Court. The Supreme Court isn't on here, guys. We're doing really well. We're doing really well. Okay. Congress, Chief Justice, President, Vice President. It has to be the President. I think the President has to sign off on them. Okay. Now I recall that. What movement tried to end racial discrimination? Am I going to get canceled if I don't know this one? The Civil Rights Movement? Civil War. I mean, I said civil rights movement, so I feel like I have to go with that. But I'm also kind of leaning towards like this as well. But I'm just gonna say civil rights movement. Yeah! We elect the president for how many years? Four! Four! The Federalist Papers, don't even know what that is, supported the passage of the US Constitution. Name one of the writers. One of the writers of the US Constitution. Benny Franklin. John Adams. Wait, no, I think I get Thomas Jefferson and Ben Franklin confused. But also Thomas Edison. John Adams sounds like an important name. Dude, I don't know. Okay, we have Abe Lincoln, Thomas Jefferson, Alexander Hamilton, George Washington. Really, I feel like any of these could be right, except Abe Lincoln. I feel like I just don't really associate him with like these guys. Did Mr. Hamilton ever sing about the US Constitution? Probably. But then we also have Thomas Jefferson and George Washington. I'm trying to think of the time frame of like when the US Constitution was written, and I don't remember. We elect a US representative for how many? I don't think it's four. And I don't think it's six either. I think six is like for the Senate. I want to say two because there's like the House of Representatives, right? I think that's what they're talking about. I feel like that's only 2 years. So I'm either incredibly right and spot on with two or incredibly wrong and it's 27. Surely not. 10 and 6 feels like a lie. I'm gonna say 2. Let's freaking go. Before he was president, Eisenhower was a general. I know nothing about Eisenhower. Literally nothing. What war was he in? I don't know when he was president. I'm gonna say the Civil War, if that's an option. I wasn't getting that one. Like, I have zero knowledge of this. It was the Second War. The Gulf War was in the 90s. The more you know. Wait, did I pass? Okay, I got 6 out of 10. I think that means I passed. Hamilton! It was Hamilton. I want to pass again. Who's the first president? George Washington. Who did the United States fight in World War II? Germany? It was like there was allies. There was a Germany and other people. Germany, Japan, and oh no. I think it was Italy. It was Italy. No. Yeah. Because Germany, okay, I know World War II. That was Hitler, Germany. Hello? I need my Rocky Mountains music in order to get these questions correct. So Hitler was Germany. I'm obviously it's Japan. And then Mussolini. Wasn't Mussolini the other general or dictator or whatever? Mussolini? I cannot remember if he was Italian or French. I'm gonna say Italian, and I feel like it's gonna be really embarrassing if I'm wrong. Phew! Italian? Yes. Senator, I know this. It's six. I'm pretty sure. Yes! House of Representatives has how many voting members? Oh my gosh. You select two from each state. So that's like 100. Or is it only 50? I don't remember. Well, 50's not an option. I'm gonna say 100. Frick. 435 sounds correct. I bet that's the correct answer. What stops one branch of government from becoming too powerful? I actually don't know this one. Confederacy and Union, House of Reps and the Senate. I don't think it's A. It's not C. So I'm gonna say checks and balances. Okay. Oh my gosh. Middle school. Thank you. Shout out to my 8th grade middle school history teacher, Mr. Davidson. He was really cool. And I think he probably taught me checks and balances. I don't remember if it was him or if it was someone else. Mr. Davidson, if you're watching, I hope you're alive still and thriving. It was checks and balances. When was the Constitution written? We were literally talking about this earlier. I'm gonna say 1820. Okay, I know this is an important year. I'm kind of leaning towards 1929. Hamilton did write the Constitution. I think we just discovered that. And the last practice test. Are you trolling? Because America came to be because they got independent from France or whoever was holding them hostage. That's when the US became independent from the... Oh, the UK. Stupid British people. When's the last day you can send in federal income tax forms? April 15th! What are two rights in the Declaration of Independence? You have the right to property and pursuit of happiness? or were those in the Constitution? It's like, is Declaration of Independence, is that the one that starts with we the people? It's like, we the people, in order to form a more perfect union, something, justice, something, something, liberty, provide for the common defense, promote the general welfare, speech and press, life and liberty. It's life and liberty. Is life, liberty, the pursuit of happiness? I've only gotten two wrong so far. Capital of the United States, Washington, D.C. Too easy. What are two ways that Americans can participate in their democracy? Voting and running for office? Or freedom of speech? Purchase a building and go on a trip. That's not democracy. Drive a car and go to a museum. Nah, I wouldn't say that's necessarily participating in democracy. Eating at a restaurant and applying for a job. Not really. I think it's D. Help with a campaign and run for office. I got 8 out of 10 correct. So this was 435 and this was 1787. I took the test twice. I believe I got a 60 the first time. Congrats! Yeah! An 80! You know, my mother, she doesn't think an 80 is a good grade. I think an 80 is a good grade. You're passing, and it's a B. Like, what do you expect from me? If you ask my mother, though, she would be like, 80 is not a good grade. But we won't get into that.
I look at that. Look at Riley being big brain.
I know!